How's it going, humans? So today, we are making a secret bookcase.
Shh.
Or another secret bookcase.
So that's right. Another secret hidden bookcase is coming your way, and it's going to be even better than the last one. We're using heavy-duty wheels. We're using a massive angle iron to support them. We have enormous hinges and...
Oh, that's neat. Oh, that's gonna happen. Yeah. Last minute plan changes, but that's cool. It's gonna have a secret. He doesn't know about this. This is a client build for an amazing guy who lives just north of me. Secret bookcase with a secret compartment. That shit's happening.
So in order to make a secret compartment in a secret bookcase, we have to first make the bookcase. So here I'm using the shelf pin technique I learned in my last video to properly line up my bookcase sides. So I cut them right the first time. So with the bookcase sides cut down and now perfectly aligned and indexed to each other, it was time to cut the middle shelf and the top shelf to size. Then I brought those over to the router table to put a little rabbet in the back so that we could attach a nailer strip for the backer board.
Boom.
So with those all dry, it was time to go back to my 9th grade home economics class and learn how to use the iron. I'm sorry, who am I kidding? I didn't take home ec in grade 9, I took woodshop. But you still need to learn how to use an iron, even if it's just for applying edge banding.
That's pretty.
Look at decoration.
Whee! So with the shelves all banded and trimmed and ready to go, I could throw the bookcase together. Well, at least two-thirds of it. But we still have to make that hidden compartment.
So now we're gonna flip it. Should be fine, right? I'm already worried about doing this. It's fine. Hey, you did it!
So with the bookcase successfully flipped, I quickly threw in a little back support, nailing strip, bottom brace thingamadoo.
Ah, shit. Why didn't you tell me the tape was still on? Come on.
I need your help. Like, I'm just a poor human.
Get out of there!
Oh my god, what are you doing? Come on.
You jerk. Most of you are probably thinking, that guy uses a lot of tape. And you'd be right.
So with that all taken care of, it was time to flip this guy over again. And then we could start to figure out how to do the shelf. But the shelf is dependent on the wheels.
How to do the wheels? That's a good question. Well, I look like dopey sometimes when I wear my hat like this. I don't know, I feel like dopey. I am dopey. That's fine. Wheels. We'll need to protrude a little bit from the bottom because I want two wheels. And we have our metal plate. I do want to do a metal corner bracket. Screwed through here because that's where the weight's going to come. Made a decision. So what we're going to do, this was never part of the plan. Remember, there's never going to be a hidden secret little cubby storage thing. It's not going to be very big. It's only gonna be
A little over 3 inches, but it's enough. 3 inches is enough for some things. So what we're gonna do, so we're gonna go 30 across, and there'll be a piece that's gonna sit in here. I'm gonna dado it in so it can slide in and out and kind of lock into place and be exactly where it needs to be. So that then the angle iron is gonna sit here, and there's gonna be the room for wherever, however I wanna mount these wheels. Cause there's gonna be two of them. There's gonna be one down here and there's gonna be one up here. So what's gonna happen after all of this is so that you can then remove that piece so that you can have access to all of these things in here for the wheel adjustment and height adjustment, which I'm going to need during install. Once it's in, it should be fine. So I'm gonna take this piece off, gonna unscrew that, and I'm going to make another one of those, and I'm going to do some dadoing and all of that rabbits. I guess a dado at the end of a thing is a rabbit, and in the middle it's a dado, because woodworking terminology is hard. So we're gonna do that. We're gonna make this shelf box bottom thing. I don't know. We're gonna do a time lapse. I'm gonna throw this camera in the corner. You can just watch me run around the shop like a madman and let me know if you like it. Imagine this is the actual width of our bookcase. Now we have these two sides with these nice channels, but underneath, rabbited like a little bunny in, it's going to be this bottom a drawer. And then we're just gonna cut a piece that will slide in here that can then be taken out if you need to maintain on the wheels that are gonna be over here in place with some angle iron. How cool is that? I am going to glue this up. And very careful, melamine is really sharp. Don't cut yourself, don't get a splinter. So, we have our drawer. We have our piece. We'll sit like a glove, like it's meant to be. I don't know why I'm talking like this, but I am. Bangarang. Oh yeah, it's a thing. It's a thing. That's not part of it. This thing, we're going to stand it up because that'll be fun. So let's stand it up. It's pretty good size. And then we're gonna cut the backer board, and then we're gonna put backer board on. And that might be it for today. Is a case for putting books in. We didn't blow through. We hit it everywhere. Did not blow a single nail through. So I'm happy. And that might be it for today. And I think tomorrow's gonna be cutting hinges. I have 8 enormous hinges to cut. That's gonna be a whole day. Because they need to be Perfect.
The hinges are the most important part of this project. Project? Progress. The hinges are the most important part. I need coffee. Hinges, good. No hinges, bad. That's how that works.